feel like I've met this new girl called Jay and I really get on with her. And I happen to work with her as well, which is great.
I hadn't ever encountered stuff like that, real life, adult stuff and politics, and I just wanted to sing and dance and spend some money and have fun.
I mean, Cheryl was another one, and so was Bobby. You know, he could throw a tantrum. We all did, but not to the extent where you become unbearable to work with.
General public of a certain age think that that's all that we were good for. Lies anymore.
You know, if we'd united, we would have been a much tougher, stronger team. Love is gone, tears are here, nothing left. Life has changed, remember when we were young.
Fans, and I saw them all standing and cheering, and I was choked and I almost couldn't sing.
And it was one of the best shows we've ever done. Dreams never die, life
sung a pretty song. And I remember crying, I cried because these guys, we hadn't seen them for 25 years.
When that coach remembers it and they say it actually haunts them to even think about it.
I remember the week of number one, we were all arguing and no one was talking to each other. And that's thinking, we're at number one and we're not talking, it's ridiculous.
When we're on stage, we look like four good buddies.
Then we had some fantastic moments, you know, there we were with palm trees going past the window and get along for your money and take a chance and it turn out right. And when you can see how it's gonna be, you're making your mind up. And in a while another day will give your fear away. And you try a smile.
But this was really special because this was 30 years on. And they were still there and they were still cheering and it just felt really poignant.